The title is To the Promised Land via Israel, and the story is the family in Exodus 14, and it is the Red Sea crossing. I know you are aware of how this happened. So they were, you know, from Egypt, they traveled to the wilderness until they reached the Red Sea. And the question is, there was this question posted in the lesson. Why did God bring the Israelites to a place where He knew they would be verified? And I didn't like the question very much, so I rephrased it. Why did God bring the Israelites to a place where He knew they would be tried? Okay? So the lesson actually is just one single thought. Sometimes God needs us to try us. Previously, we have been talking about the crucible and how that relates to our suffering, our trials, whatever hardships we encounter from the environment, sometimes from our own doing. But this week, it was telling us that God could also lead us to our crucible. Okay? So, following God, the Israelites have been following God all throughout the desert. How did you get the chief disciples? There was this pillar of cloud by day, pillar of fire by night. So wherever the pillar goes, the Israelites go. Actually, the Bible also says that it was God himself, I suspect Jesus, the angel of the Lord, leading them, saying unto someone. Okay? So following God doesn't always mean happiness. Okay. We have learned last week that we should not be surprised when trials come our way, right? So we need to follow God. So naturally, when you follow God, you would be walking behind Him. But if you imagine Harris and myself walking down the train, and Harris would be leading, I would be at the back. Okay, so I could just see down the road. I would only see the back of Paris, right? You know, that large back. Okay? You wouldn't see that the road. Why? But you don't care, because whatever obstacle you find on that road, Paris would have to see it. So if the obstacle is enough to stumble, you know, for a person to stumble, he would stumble first. Right? So that's the idea of following God. You will not be leading the way. It will be God leading the way. Okay? So, what do you see in front of you? You only see the back of God. Okay? It's not difficult. Okay? You remember that story when Moses wanted to see, you know, God's face? Imagine. Tell you what to do. Calling you out of your career as a general in Egypt, leading to a shepherd, and then making you a leader. Okay? So Moses wanted to see God's face. But later, you know, God had other plans. God said, don't look at my face was not seen. You only get to see my back. Okay? So that's what happened. But then, later on, we know that Moses would be in heaven and probably chatting with Jesus all day long. Okay? So when that means, you do not see what's ahead. And it's also the essence of the wilderness temptation. They could only see the sea, you know? So here you are, facing the sea, and you know, there's no turning back because the end is there. Okay? So they are just facing, and they're looking at this sea. No? And there's no more road. It's the sea. Okay? And what's so bad about that? You know, I have always found the truth to the sea, to the beach. Yeah. Don't you? I've always been anticipating, you know, they were most enjoyable, especially. What I like to do is just sit on a chair maybe I'll find a hammock somewhere and watch the waves, you know, sleep. This is one of the beaches that they do in the physical land. It's calming and relaxing. But for these very nice, it's not, it's a dead thing. You know, they look at the sea and they were terrified. You know, they could see the enemy coming. They panic. Why? What would you do if you were in the stream? Okay? So, you have two options. You have faith. Okay? And you know who it is because you have been following. You not panic. But if they say this, they say that here in Israel, we are going to die. We are surely going to die. The sea in front of us, the enemy behind us, what just could happen? Okay? They invade